Hi guys, in the last video of Consignment Accounts, we have seen the introduction of invoice price. Now, let us see the accounting treatment when goods are sent at an invoice price. So when the goods are sent at an invoice price, everything will be based on the invoice price. Goods sent on consignment, we take it on the debit side of the consignment account. So this will be recorded at an invoice price. Similarly, the closing stock, which is credited in the consignment account, will also be valued at an invoice price. So we know if the goods sent on consignment is debited, then the goods returned by the consignee will be credited. And if the closing stock is credited, then the next year opening stock will be debited. Fine? Alright. So all these four items needs to be adjusted by eliminating the loading from these items. Now, what is loading? Loading is the difference between the invoice price and the cost price. Let's say the cost price of an item is 100 and the invoice price of an item is 150. So the difference between these two, the invoice price and the cost price, would be the loading. That is 100 minus 150 equal to 50 rupees. Fine? So now let us understand this treatment with the help of a small example, how to remove the loading from these following items. But now I will focus only on these two items, that is goods sent on consignment and closing stock. These two, the opening stock and the goods returned, we will do that in the later problems. Alright? Now let us solve this example and understand the accounting treatment and how to prepare the consignment account when the consignor sends goods to the consignee at the invoice price. So here in this example, the consignor has sent 10 cycles costing 1000 rupees but invoiced at 1200. So here one thing you need to understand is that there is the cost of each cycle is 1000 but the invoice price is 1200. Fine? Now the consignee has received all the goods, all the cycles, and sold only 8 cycles at the price 1500. So now we will prepare the consignment account and see how to make the consignment account. So first we will take two goods sent on consignment as usual. But the only thing will be different here is that before we used to debit here the cost price. But now, since the consignor has sent the goods to consignee at the invoice price, so we'll take the invoice price, that is 1200. How many cycles? 10 cycles. He sent 10 cycles, right? So 10 into 1200 is equal to 12,000. Fine? After that, the consignee sold 8 cycles at the price 1500. So the sales will come on the credit side as by consignee, which is 8 into 1500. It's given in the question. The quantity and the price is given in the question. So by consignee, 8 into 1500 is equal to 12,000. All right. After that, now here if you see, we have debited the invoice price, not the cost price. Before we used to debit the cost price, but since here we have debited the invoice price, there is cost and profit in it. The cost is 10,000, which is 10,000, and the profit, which is the difference between the invoice price and the cost price, 200. So that 200 into 10 is 2000. 10,000 plus 2000 equal to 12,000. So since there is profit in it, the debit side has been increased. So if debit side has been increased, then our expenditure of consignor increases. If expenditure of consignor increases, then the profit will be decreased. So the profit will not be correct, because we know that the debit side is the expenditure side of the consignment account. So if expenditure increases, the profit decreases. We cannot arrive at the correct profit if we leave this profit as it is. So we have to remove that profit. We have to eliminate that profit. So to eliminate that profit, we must credit here by goods sent on consignment. Now, why are we crediting it? Because here it is debited. So remove that debit, we have to make an equal credit. So here that 2000 profit is debited. So to remove that, we have to credit 2000 profit. This is also called as the loading, the removal of the profit. Fine. Alright, next, here only 8 cycles are sold, so there is 2 cycles left, so there is a stock left, so that stock must be valued by consignment stock, which is 2 into, okay, now we will value the consignment stock at the invoice price, because the goods were sent at an invoice price, right? So we'll value the consignment stock at the invoice price. 2 into 1200, which is equal to 2400. All right. Now, before we used to value the stock at the cost price, but in this problem, we have valued it at invoice price. So here also there is an element of profit, cost plus profit. The cost is 2 into 1000 is 2000. 2 into 200 is the profit. That is 400. So 2000 plus 400 is the valuation of stock here. Alright. So we have to remove that profit to arrive at the correct profit. Similarly, as in the goods sent on consignment. This is the revenue side, right? Revenue side of the consignment account. If revenue is more, then the profit will be more. But it will be overvalued profit, not the true and correct profit. So to arrive at the correct and true profit, we must eliminate this profit. So to eliminate this profit, we have to debit here to stock reserve. To stock reserve. That is 2 into. What is the difference between the cost price and the invoice price? The cost was 1000 and the invoice price was 1200. So the difference is 200, right? 1200 minus 1200. So that is the profit, right? 2 into 200 is 400. Why 2? Because 2 cycles are left. So 2 into 200, which is equal to 400. All right. Now we'll balance the consignment account. Credit side is bigger. 12,000 plus 2000 plus 2400 is equal to 16,400. So here also we'll write that on the both the sides. 16,400 minus these two, 16,400 minus 12,000 and 400, which is equal to 4,000. Now 4,000 will be the profit on consignment, profit and loss, profit on consignment, right? This is the true and correct profit. All right.